Hi, everybody. How are you, remote wolfies? This is Ms. Nunez here to tell you about what you're going to do for the week of February 15th. So you're going to see me picking up some speed in trying to get us through our ILit for the year. And it's important for you to do the best you can on your assignments in order to achieve proficiency. The most important assignments are the interactive readers. And in order to score a 3, you've got to have 30 to 33 points. If you look at your notebook, the green finger notebook, and open it and look under the tab of my work, you can see all the assignments you've had since the beginning, and they're organized by lessons. So right now, we did start unit 3, but I didn't notice that there was one more at the very bottom. So I didn't notice that there was one more lesson down here. So the assignments that I'm going to send you are the last ones in Unit 2 from Lesson 41 through 45. Pretty soon, I'll click Interactive Reader for you. And if you are reading at the ninth grade level, you're probably getting one of these a little bit higher on the quality and difficulty of the assignment. And that's based on the middle of the year test that many of you still haven't finished. Hello, hello. I also want to remind you that you have a presentation to record. And if you look at the link, it is under True Colors. And what you're gonna do there is click record, and you can watch my example one that will show you how to present on your personality. So back to this week's assignments, you're going to get an interactive reader. The next one of the minis is a word match. So there, you're going to have a question and you drag and drop one of the words from the left side. So you have a word match. The word slams are the ones that have a little box at the top right. Don't forget to look at that. So that little box there has all these really hard words. So if you amplify the sound, you make it louder. If somebody likes anarchy, they believe in no government and no police. A bunker is like the little hills, sometimes made out of sandbags, where the soldiers shoot. So they get behind the bunker to shoot their guns. Contemptuously is acting like, I don't care, being kind of rude. So somebody can be in contempt. Sometimes when you're watching TV, you will hear the judge say, you are in contempt. And the judge can actually have you kicked out, fine you, or even arrest you if you're being disrespectful in the court. Deactivated is like when an account doesn't work anymore and they deactivate an account or a card. Deploy is when they send somebody out, usually in the military. So you can be deployed to Iraq or Afghanistan, something like that. If you despise something, you hate it. If somebody is hobbling, they can barely walk and they hobble. Innovation is when something is new and creative, and portable, you can take it with you. So what you're gonna do is put the words together and based on the definition, said or done in a manner that shows someone or something is being disrespectful, So I just went over those words and hopefully you'll get a good score on that. Then I'm going to send you determined text structure. Now, when you have a structure, it's the way kind of like a building is created from the bottom up. A text can be structured different ways. Usually they follow PEEL. So a point, evidence, examples, explanations, and details. And then they analyze and then conclude. Other times you can have a compare and contrast. My sister's like this, 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 this. I am like that, 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 that. And both of us are similar in some ways. Or you can go sister and myself, sister and myself, sister and myself, and a conclusion. So there's different kinds of structures in the text. The most common ones are compare and contrast. You can actually look this up. Five, let's go with five. Something can be a description with a PEEL structure. Something can be in sequence. So there was a big fight in the street yesterday. First, somebody started screaming stuff, and finally. So it can be in chronological order. Another text structure is cause. So there have been a lot of issues around global warming. This has created melting in the ice caps. There has also been a lot of drowning of the polar bears, et cetera, et cetera. So you can have a cause and effect. Compare and contrast, like I told you, and problem and solution. So smoking causes many problems. The problems are lung cancer, heart disease, and wasted money. People ought to get more information just about how harmful. If we educate people, we would have no more problems with smoking, etc. So those are the text structures, and you're going to explain the text structure of a little paragraph about birds. The grammar, you have seen this kind of thing before. You have some questions, and then you have a middle one, and a post. The study is like, that's the one I just did. And word reading moves you right along. And this is when you need to record yourself at the end. So some of you have simply been, I think this is a recording, but anyway, you drag the and drop, and then it gets, I mean, these are really, really easy, very elementary, my dear Watson. So those are the assignments you're getting. You are to Zoom with me one time a week. I'm opening at 1:30 to 2. And I also want you to email me and tell me how you're doing. We have been in school for 6 months now. And let's see, we have March, April, May, and then we say goodbye. Your assignments are looking awfully blank. So let's get to work on these, okay? Every week, I will see if you did that week's assignment. Today is Friday. I will mark you absent if you didn't finish that week's assignments. So I'm not taking attendance for September. We are now where we are and opening all the previous, you know, lessons and really old stuff. I will, but I'm not going to count you present with this week's assignments if you're doing the old stuff. So get caught up, okay? All right, and take care. Let me know if I can be of help at all. See ya. Adios.